What in the world is child doing? What are you doing in here? What are you doing? It's like stuff everywhere.
I'm organizing my clothes for Trinity's birthday. I know we're going shopping, but it's too many clothes and I need room. So.
Oh my goodness. Well, I'm proud of you. So she's finally doing it, ladies and gentlemen. Dun, da, 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 da. So wait, the stuff on the floor, is that the stuff we're giving away?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Good job.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Ooh, I guess I better go. What? Invisible pants? Oh, I'm going to wear those tomorrow.
Okay.
Well, I think I'll just go back to my office and pretend I don't see anything. It's the vacuum. Okay, all right. Okay, Shirley. First, she's cleaning her closet. She said she was cleaning out her room. She was like taking stuff out the closet that even she wanted to frame. And now vacuum? Is there a surprise party going on up in this space that I don't know about? Nothing in the hall anymore. Oh boy. She's downstairs, so what is clean? Oh my goodness. What happened to all the stuff? Oh yeah, you can see the vacuum marks. Okay. Alright, germ roll. Oh my goodness. No way. Color-coded, she finished it. Oh, my goodness. Her shoes, her pants. Oh, goodness. It is so clean in here. I think she's trying to get an award. Well, she wins. She wins. She wins the award.
So guys, I have way too much stuff in my closet. I just have to get rid of it. So I'm gonna do a little research so I can find a place to donate. And I also have enough room for one, my new outfit that I'm getting for Trinity's birthday party and some new spring clothes.
Spot, I was real proud of you looking up where you wanted to donate your stuff to, but why this spot versus what we normally donate?
Well, this place allows people to get the stuff for free.
And you get to shop for free?
Yeah. So the stuff that we have in there, it's like
wow. All
different good shoes and all different types of different clothes.
US 29.
All right, cool. Well, I'm excited. This is really cool. People get to shop for free.
Yep.
Wow. You know, it's really cool that you want to bless somebody else. I'm real proud of you.
Thanks, Mom.
You're welcome, sweetie. You're such a great kid.
I'm at the mall, and I don't know what I want to wear. It's like, what should I wear? Oh, this is nice. Do you like it? I'm gonna go try it on and see.
You like the shirt?
Yeah, that's really cute. I like the shoulders, huh? Oh gosh. Yeah, that's cute.
the color
skirt. Okay, I really like that. Do you like it?
Yeah, I like the other one. This one's better.
Yeah, turn around. Let's see that.
It's drawer too.
Yeah, that's cute. Oh, that is gonna look awesome. With some holy jeans?
Yes.
Sweet. Thumbs up. Yeah.
I think it comes together quite nicely. So this morning, I cleaned out my closet, donated it to the donation center. I went to the mall, and now get ready for Vanessa to come over. It's math tutoring.
Hi, so I'm Vanessa, and I got a lot of roles. But I guess my most important role would be Chef Victoria Elizabeth's big sister.
Boy, you write tinier than anyone I have ever known. You can't do the math in that space.
But I have no room. That's okay, not enough
so
room.
Then get another piece of paper.
But this is wasting paper.
This is math class.
I'm trying to
and
see
you're just
the
gonna
trees.
Do all the math on the calculator.
Yes, that's what we do all the time. But
then you're not doing much math if you're just calculating it.
But why do we have calculators then?
What?
It's for on the go.
This is, do you know what math class is for? It's to help deepen your mind. You're strengthening the knowledge.
Well, tell
you
Ms.
go,
Peterson.
Just like when you're exercising, you exercise until you're sore, because it helps your muscles get stronger. So if you go deeper in your math, then your brain gets stronger.
But
there's enough room. You can write out the formula inside the shape, but you can't do the math.
Yes, because it's not enough room, Vanessa. You gotta understand that.
So guys, this is middle school that Chef's in. You think all students would be expected to write out their work, write out their equations? But Chef says that she writes too big. She doesn't have room. Just look at this. Just zoom in on that. Chef writes smaller than anyone I ever knew. Not enough room, though. Not enough space.
I believe it. It's not enough room. See? I don't even have enough room to finish the problem. I guess Vanessa's right. But let's just get on with the show. Wait, hold on. I gotta tell y'all what we're cooking. So, Dewey made some dry omelets, doing a bacon, egg, and cheese one, and then a sausage and peppers. Can't wait to try that one. And then a mushroom, spinach, and fennel one. So, let's just go on with it.
So, Chef said she was gonna cook for us today, but eggs. At like 1 in the afternoon. Like, Kenny and I are just trying to chill, but I mean, that's cool though, we'll eat them.
Today is all about breakfast. We're gonna be making some good mason jar omelets, so let's get cooking. So you can see how while it's boiling, you wanna make sure it gets a good boil there. And the first omelet that we're gonna be doing is our sausage omelet. So we have some peppers here. I'm gonna cut some peppers. We have some red, yellow, and orange peppers. They're not spicy, but they give it the nice flavor and that nice color that we need. And if you do want something spicy in there, you can always put jalapenos in there. But that's just a little secret I'm not gonna use today. And guys, this is the best dish for me and my mom. Some days she doesn't get to eat breakfast, and some days I forget to eat breakfast. And you can always just pop these in the microwave, and I can sometimes sneak in lunch. So we have a shallot here. We're gonna go ahead and dice this shallot. This shallot's kind of a mix of onion and garlic. It gives that nice flavor. I love shallots. Okay. Go ahead and put this back in the bowl. And then we have some cilantro. We're gonna put a little bit of cilantro in there. Cilantro gives it that good color and flavor too. Put a couple more in there. Okay, let's go over to our sausage. We're we're gonna put our sausage on medium high heat. We're gonna let that heat up a little bit. I'm using a non-stick pan so you don't have to put any oil on there. So our pan's nice and hot. We're gonna go ahead and put our sausage in. And what we're gonna do with this sausage is as it cooks, we're gonna chop it so it's nice and fine and you don't get big clumps when you're trying to eat it. And when it's almost done, we're gonna add in our pepper, shallots, and cilantro mixture all in there. And add in our mixture. That's awesome. Get a nice good stir. You see how the pepper, they got cooked, sausage is getting cooked, and then everything's really cooked now. Go ahead and put this in the bowl so we can make our omelets. We're gonna start on our spinach and mushroom mixture. This pan on medium high heat, and then you can see how I cut the spinach. They're kind of like in little strips. You don't want to leave them whole, so you can all have the flavors, and they're not as hard to eat. I'm gonna put a little bit of oil in the pan. Maybe that's come off there. Add our mushrooms in. Give it a little stir a little bit. Get a little bit of salt and pepper in there. There we go. Give that a little stir. And just like the peppers, when these are almost done, we're gonna add in our spinach. And you can see how our mushrooms are almost done there. We're gonna add our spinach. And guys, remember, the spinach is gonna wilt down. Okay. That's all our spinach. Go ahead and turn the heat off. I'm gonna go ahead and put our mixture back in the bowl. Now let's put it all together. So first we're gonna start on our bacon, egg, and cheese omelet. I'm gonna spray it with a little bit of cooking oil so nothing sticks. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna add some egg white. Just the white, not the yolk. I'm gonna add a little bit of bacon. Good amount of bacon in there. Gonna add a little bit of scallions. And then some cheese. Good amount of cheese. Just that much, not too much. And then we're gonna crack another egg white on top. Okay, there you go. Now you got it. Now we're gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper in there. Everything won't work today. A little bit of pepper. Now we just have to do it two more times. Let's go ahead and put our lids on. Make sure they're nice and tight. So you wanna make sure nothing comes out. And we're gonna put it in our pan. Now let's get started on our sausage roll. We're gonna actually do the same thing here. Spread it. And then we're gonna put in our sausage. Yeah. Make sure you get it all around in there. Make sure you get all the peppers, all the shallots, everything in there. Gonna throw in a little bit of cheese. Put it in there. And then we're gonna crack an egg. There's that. Now we just gotta do it twice. We're gonna salt and pepper these too. Last one, guys. These flavors from the veggies are gonna pop and taste so good. So let's get our three mason jars. Spray them. And then what we're gonna do, sit this inside, have our bowl. So here we have 6 eggs. In this, we're gonna be using the whole egg. Okay. And what we're gonna do with this is we're gonna whisk it up. And, but we're gonna go ahead and whisk these. Gonna whisk. Oh, one more thing I almost forgot. We want to salt and pepper our eggs. Salt. Pepper. And we're gonna whisk them really, really good. Like, really, really good. Okay? And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna evenly put it into 3. And remember, half of this is gonna go on the bottom, half of this is gonna go on the top, so don't use too much. So I'm just gonna pour a little bit here. And that should be enough to go ahead and put on the top. So, we have our spinach and our mushroom mixture. I'm gonna put that in. We're gonna add a little bit of minced garlic on top. Just a little bit. We have some feta cheese here. Guys, feta cheese is a very strong flavor and it's really good. Our mozzarella, a little bit of mozzarella there. And then we have some parmesan to top it off. And then we're gonna put in our egg and put it on top. That's how it is. Now we're gonna go ahead and put the tops on. And if you do want some extra salt and pepper, you can always put it at the very end when it comes out. Make sure it gets nice and tight. These look really good. Omelette mason jars. There you go. You want about that much water? So they've been in the oven for 25 minutes. I've poured the water out, so now I'm gonna take them out and cool. Okay. We're gonna let those cool for about 5 minutes so the tops are nice and cool to take them out. They cooled, so let's go ahead and pop them open. Oh, look at that, it smells so good.
Zoom in there, you have the bacon, you got the cheese, got the scallions, so good. Let's go ahead and let's check our sausage one. Put that to the side. You can see here, you can look in, you got the cheese, you got the peppers, you got the sausage. So good. Now let's check our last one, our spinach. Now this one looks good. You can kind of see, I see that ooey gooeyness right there.
There you go. So guys, see you next time. Bye.
And this is what happens after the show. After the show, the people from under the stairs come. They all begin to eat the food.
A lot of flavor.
It tastes good, Victoria. You did a good job.
I did good.
Kenny, your thoughts?
That was good.
It's really good.
Oh. I really like the feta and spinach one a lot. I didn't think I liked feta. Hmm? Really? Is that what we do now? Seriously?
So we ate the eggs and, I mean, I gotta give it to Chef. I really liked them, especially that spinach one. Oh, man. I wonder what she's cooking tomorrow. I'm gonna have to come back.
I hope you guys enjoyed the show. And those Mason jar omelets were fantastic. So, let's get down to business. Do you have those things that you don't want inside your house? Well, give those things to donation centers, either to places that give those things to people for free or for a lower cost. And that can really help our community. Make sure you come at the same time next week because we're gonna be meeting some new people and going to some cool places. And did you miss last week's episode or any of this week's episode? Well, check me out on YouTube at Victoria's Kitchen and check out those videos. And also, you can hit me up on at Chef Victoria Elizabeth at Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And also for any information about my TV show or any recipes, it's at victoriacooks.com. So see you next time. Bye. Bacon, egg and cheese one.
What's wrong with you?
I have words.
Oh, because we messed up the what?
What's up with that look?
I was waiting to you to do something. Oh. Sorry that you were recording.
So you're going to go back after this. Just this puppy.